Ajay Deshpande. Dr. Ajay, graduated from Parbhani Veterinary College in year 1992. Then he joined Takeshwara Hatcheries Private Limited, a pure line poultry breeding company. During his tenure, he got a opportunity to work under the guidance of Dr. Solanki, Dr. Anil Padke and Dr. Kotaya. During his work experience, he has worked in various capacities such as training vet, officer, farm manager to general manager in production as well as technical services. In the year 2000, he left the job and started his own consultancy services to the breeder and broiler farmers. In the year 2004, he decided to pursue his dreams and started own breeder farm. In the year 2011, he has taken vigorous expansion of breeder farm operations to 1 lakh capacity. In the year 2013, he has also entered into the contract broiler farming and presently placing around 11 lakhs plus broiler chicks per month. He made all of us proud by his distinguished work and great success. The man of distinct vision, an idol of knowledge as well as experience and inspiration to all of us. So ladies and gentlemen, we all welcome Dr. Ajay Deshpande with a round of applause.
Good morning everybody. What is today's hatching egg prize and chick prize? Well, I think this is the most burning topic of this season, I think so. Because optimizing broiler breeder performance has become unique when hatching eggs and chick prices are touching skies. So my presentation doesn't deal with how to grade the birds, how to handle the breeders and all those things. But I wanted to share with you what the precision feeding, how the precision feeding in broiler breeders is important. This is because broiler breeders are totally different from layers and broilers. What is the basic difference between broilers, broiler farming, layer farming and breeder farming? In layer we are giving ad libitum feed, in broilers we do. But in breeders what happens? We are giving a recommended quantum of feed. So here there is lot of importance in precise feeding of breeders. Because in layers and broilers, if something is deficient, they will get it by altering the feed consumption. For example, if in layers, different energy combinations feed can be formulated. If there is less energy in the feed, bird compensate by eating more. Same is the case with broilers. But what about breeders? So how to feed your breeders precisely? That defines your performance. So there are many points to consider, like management, feeding, healthcare, photo period, that can have a bearing on the economics of production. But my presentation today attempts to how explain precise feeding to meet the energy and protein requirement of the modern day broiler breeder to optimize performance. So I want to ask you one question. What type of records do you keep as a breeder farmer? What type of records daily you have to keep to precisely feed the breeders? And what happens if they are energy deficient, if they are protein deficient? Many people ask me, how much peak feed you give to your breeders? If I think or it's whether this question is right or wrong, how much peak feed do you give to your breeders? What does it mean? Tell me first, what do you have in your feed? what is the energy content of your feed, what is the protein content of your feed, what is the body weight of your breeder, what is egg weight of your breeder, what is egg mass, which will decide how much peak feed has to be given to the breeder. So, when you think of optimizing breeder performance, these three important factors are there. Body weight and condition of the pullet. It is not sufficient that you attain the body weight only. Body condition means body conformation, fleshing of the bird. So along with the weight, that is also very important. If your birds are underweight, you can overfeed them and they will achieve the body weights. But that should not be there. So birds should be conditioned. There should be fleshing of the birds. Second thing is energy requirement of the bird, and third is protein requirement of the bird. So if you look at the body weights of the breeders, you can get it from the manuals. But we don't have the information on how to keep the problem flocks close to these suggested weights. That is missing. And this is the art. So you need to be with the birds always. You need to work with the birds always. You know what is piercing index? Piercing index. It is developed by the experience, you know. Many of vets are so much experienced that when they look at the birds, they can know what is going wrong in the birds. That is piercing experience. So this comes by experience. You see, 6 week body weight broiler chicks, female bird, weighs 1.8 kg, and 6 week broiler breeder pullet have to maintain a 600 weight kgs. From this, it is evident that overweight pullet is the problem, not the underweight in broiler breeders. So what we need to focus and what is important during the rearing period? So overall pullet, in overall pullets, we should not reduce the feed. Feed should be held at the same level until body weight comes in line with that recommended for their given age. Then adjustment in feed allowance should be made to hold pullets to the desired weight curve. Next, ensure pullet attain mature pullet weight, and they should be carrying sufficient body flesh also, and this can be judged by feeling the flesh over the keel. This is most important point. Pullet lacking in flesh, they are immature birds and will be delayed coming into production. Increase feed if necessary to ensure well-fleshed pullets and delay live stimulation of the flock until proper condition has been achieved. Delay light hurt, we should not, once the body weights are attained, we should not rush for photosensation, means artificial light stimulation, all of those things. They will not respond unless and until they are properly conditioned. Now move on to the energy requirement of the breeders. This is, I'm going into this totally different concept. I don't know whether anybody is thinking in this angle or not. But what I'm practicing at my breeder farm is this concept only. These are two major costly nutrients, energy and protein. So here are the important points to think upon. While protein requirements are often be major consideration of most producers, usually it is energy, the most costly dietary nutrient, which has the most influence on the performance. I will go to the table next. Varying in which tells us the how energy is important and partitioning how the pullets or hens, they partition the energy throughout their life cycle. This is a table. If you look at the table, there is an experiment carried out. This is data selected and rearranged from Pearson and Heron. You look at the first column. Is a consumption of 449 kilocalories of energy by the brooder pullet. weight at 60 week is 3.960 kgs, and egg per bird is cumulative bird up to 60 week 157.5. As the consumption of the energy per breeder pullet reduces, look at the number of hen house production. From 157.5, if 385 kilocalories is there, it is 156.6. If your birds are consuming 315 kilocalories, it is 140. And if it is 270, it is only 101. So there is a lot of difference. The relation of this energy consumption is also reflected into egg weight also. 65.3 is the highest egg weight achieved if you are feeding your birds with approximately 450 kilocalories of energy. So this is varying energy energy intake by approximately 40% has marked effect on the production parameters, which is illustrated in the table. But similar change in protein intake has little effect on performance. Let us move on to protein. Protein consumption of 27 gram per bird per day has resulted into 136 eggs hen house production, and if bird is consuming 16.5 gram of protein, it is 142.1. If you compare energy and protein, the variation in energy consumption has a wide gap in hen house production as compared to the protein consumption. So I am focusing more on to the energy intake by the pullet and breeder hen. So let us come to the energy. It is called the fire of life. Feed supplies energy is required for growth, egg production, maintenance, and vital life functions. This may include a growth component, but the main consideration is egg mass output. So how many of us are calculating egg mass on daily basis? May I know who are the breeders over here, who are handling the breeders? What is egg mass? How it is calculated? Are you keeping record of egg mass? Because breeder birds, body weight and egg mass are the two main components which decide the energy requirement of the breeder bird. Now we'll move ahead. Factors that influence energy requirement of the broiler breeder. What are those factors? One is body size. Second is environmental temperature. Third is production, growth, and egg mass output. Here the body size is very important. How many of us are able to maintain body weight, breeder body weight, to the manual standard? How many of us are able to maintain the body weights that are the standard mentioned in the manual? Very few, I think so. And these body weights, they determine the energy requirement for maintenance. Many times we make mistakes. So we don't stick up to the body weights, standard body weights. But we argue with the feed quantum, and that has mentioned in the manual. Is 168 gram is the peak feed it should be. But what is your body weight? Are they to the standard? Then you can stick up to the 168 gram. Because 168 gram feed, how much energy it is giving to the bird, and how the bird is partnering that energy to the production and maintenance. So once you know that, it is art, you know, it is experience. Once you know that, you won't ask a question, how much peak feed you give. Second is environmental temperature. Third is production, growth, and egg mass output. These influencing factors. Again, environmental temperature, whatever manual has suggested, they are guidelines, you know. And variations in the temperature, minus and plus to the comfort zone, comfort zone. What is the comfort zone of temperature? It is say 15 to 30 degree. So below 15 degree, how much energy requirement of the bird increases? We have to calculate. So minus side, it is a different energy requirement, and plus side also it is a different energy requirement. We'll move to the next slide. Now we'll come to the maintenance energy requirement of the energy for maintenance. This makes up by far the greatest percent of the bird's total energy requirement. A number of equations have been developed which give reasonable estimates of the total energy requirement of the broiler breeder. However, as with any predicted estimate, such values must be evaluated for each and every situation. Because situation differ from farm to farm. Whatever water quality I have at my farm, other may not be having. Water quality also has an influence on energy requirement. So this is a predicted energy requirement of broiler breeder pullet to 20 weeks of age. Remember, this is the most important period, particularly from 14 weeks to 20 weeks, where you are conditioning your pullets for the better production. So this is predicted energy requirement. You see, I have given the age in weeks and body weights, roughly standard body weights, and total energy requirement, and how much the pullet partition that energy for its maintenance. You see, in second week, they partition only 50%, 57% of the energy, diet energy, for the maintenance. But as they grow, as they progress in the age, look at the 20 weeks. Here, the 84% of the energy they consume is going to maintain its body weight only. So one need to understand this factor very well, and one need to learn how to calculate the energy requirement of the bird for better productivity. What this above table reveals, as the bird increases in age, larger body size, the maintenance energy requirement increases as a percentage of total energy requirement, until by the latter part of the growing period, over 80% of the energy consumed is used to just maintain the pullet. So are you giving enough energy to maintain the bird? Are you giving extra energy for the production, what bird needs? So we need to calculate. And this is the most scientific and experienced way to calculate the feed allotment. So this period from say 16 week to onset of production is very critical, and the decisions during this period will have a long term effect on overall production and economics of the breeding. Now move on to next. It's a very interesting again. The energy requirement for maintenance from 20 weeks to 68 weeks. Put a marker, put a marker. Pointer, pointer. Okay. So if you look at carefully to this table, here the maintenance energy requirement from 20 weeks to 68 weeks has been mentioned. For 20 weeks, it's total 300 kilocalorie requirement. This is predicted requirement of energy. And look at the maintenance energy, how it goes. From 83 to 80, means almost 80% of the energy birds consume, that will go into just maintain the pullet. So my point here is, Are you only giving maintenance ration to the bird? How to will at this? Many do complain that my flocks doesn't reach the peak production. Many complain that my production goes above 80% but didn't sustain. So what is the cause? Is it health or is it management or is it nutritional? So I have to find out. I need to keep all the records and study well so that bird will not be energy deficient. So as far as my experience goes, I think many of the breeders, they are underfeeding their birds. So something is lacking there. They are not getting sufficient energy, or getting energy only just to maintain the pullet or maintain the hen. Have anybody calculated what is the energy requirement of the bird? Are we giving enough feed or enough energy to the birds? And that is the very important factor. Look at the period from 28 to 44. Predicted energy requirement of the broiler breeder. It is 400, 450, 450, 450, 450. From 32 to 42, I think so. So it is energy requirement is constant. So what generally we commit mistakes? Our birds are already overweight. So we get panic that my bird is overweight. If I put more feed, then they will put on more weight. And with that worries, immediately after the birds reach peak production, we start reducing the feed. But if you deeply study this factor, this is the maintenance energy. And it is sustains for almost 10 weeks. I don't know whether you are getting these points. Yeah, okay. Here the key points to be noted: the maintenance energy requirement is around 80% of the total energy intake. This decreases noticeably at peak production and continues to peak egg mass when the hen would be partitioning a significant portion of its energy intake to meet its requirement of egg mass output. During this period, feed increments and reduction need to be decided based on the total energy requirement of the hen. So what normally we practice, the feed increment and reduction program, what is the scientific base for that? As the production rises, we go on increasing the feed. So what is scientific tool to reduce the feed? What is the base for that? If production goes 5% below, we reduce the 5 gram of feed. Is it true? So how to calculate that one? I am coming to next. Total energy requirement peaks around peak egg mass production and then declines as the requirement for egg mass production is reduced as egg production decreases. The fact is, around 20% of energy intake of the hen is diverted into egg production and increased body weight. That is very fairly small. If you look at the standard body weight gain throughout the laying period, it is very less marginally. In latter part, it is hardly 10 grams per week, 30, 10 grams, 45 grams. So it is very marginal. Since the hen will preferentially partition nutrients to meet her requirement for maintenance, if her feed allowance is not sufficient to meet her total energy requirement, egg mass output and thus egg production or egg size will be reduced. This point need to be think upon, you know, is a very serious point. What is egg mass? How it is calculated? That is the basis for anticipating or calculating the energy requirement of the bird. It's a percent of production into egg weight. So what record you need to have? You need to have egg weight, daily egg weight and average weekly egg weight of the broiler breeder hens. That is very important. because egg production multiplied by egg weight divided by 100 is egg mass output. So I am coming to the reducing feed intake post peak production. This is very important. Important observations what I observed. Common practice, reduce feed allowance to a flock shortly after peak production is attained. This may lead to drop in production shortly after peak is attained. Peak egg mass output is not attained until several weeks after peak egg production. If you got 85% production, this doesn't mean that you have attained the peak egg mass, because it is related to egg weight also. So for several weeks after peak production, egg mass goes on increasing. And whether you are considering, whether we are considering this factor while reducing the feed intake, as because your birds are already heavy weight, in panic you start reducing the feed after the peak is attained, which to my point is incorrect. Let's calculate. Here is an example. An average egg weight of 65 gram. For production of one egg of 65 gram, estimated energy requirement is 140 kilocalorie. If feed is 160 gram per bird per day at peak production, diet containing 2800 kilocalorie energy, the intake of energy will be 448 kilocalorie metabolized per bird per day. If 140 kilocalorie are required for the production of one egg, this means that approximately 31% of the hen's energy is going towards egg production at this time. This is very important. So at egg mass output at 85% production with 65 gram egg weight will be 55.3 gram per hen per day. I am proving this scientifically, you know, because there are thumb rules. If production drops to 5%, reduce the feed by 5 gram. How it is wrong, I have explained this here. And how to calculate it, that is the illustration of how to calculate it is. If production drops to 80% and egg weight increases by 1 gram, egg mass output would be 52.8. So what it was earlier with 85% production? It was 55.3 gram. So now it has come to 52.8 gram. Thus egg mass output would be 55.3 minus 52.8, this is means 4.5%. Egg mass output has gone down by 4.5%. Okay. Hence the energy required per hen per day for egg production, it is 6.3 kilocalorie. We need to precisely calculate this one while feed reduction program. If everybody is getting this one, this concept. You see at the, which one earlier?
No, this one. Explain again.
Again, okay. You see, in earlier slide, we have taken production percentage of 85. Okay. The production, when it was 85%, the egg mass was 55.3 gram. Okay. You got this point. Now from 85, it has come down to 80%.
Yes, I
understood. Okay. Okay, sir, you understood now. So how much percentage of egg mass has come down? It is 4.5% only. And if 4.5% of egg mass has come down, how much energy? It is 6.3 kilocalorie of energy. Thus for 4.5% drop in egg mass output, total diet energy requirement has only dropped to, I keep this separately, you know, it is energy required for egg mass and energy required for production. So I am thinking of only egg production now. So total, in totality if you consider, the energy requirement has gone down by 1.4% only, and not the 5% that one might estimate from the drop in egg production. And where we commit mistakes, I also used to commit these mistakes. When I studied this table and gone into depth of this, then I realized that whatever we were doing earlier, it was totally wrong. Decrease in feed intake after production has to be precisely calculated, as the hens requirement is not related directly to the drop in egg mass output. There is a strong possibility that
5 minutes.
I have to go another half an hour because another protein component will be there. If you wish to, I can stop it.
No. I was told to keep the time of 35 minutes. So I just given the bell at 30 minutes, 5 more minutes. What I would suggest is you can take some more time and go a little faster so that the important topic on protein also could be covered.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
We will extend the program for tomorrow.
So, second point is, there is a strong possibility that the broiler breed is deficient in energy intake up to and perhaps beyond peak egg mass production. How much of us calculate this one? Because this is a key for optimizing the broiler breeder performance. Many of us do lot of gradings, lot of uniformity, we work hard. But if we don't able to calculate the precise requirement of the broiler breeder, you won't be able to optimize the breeder performance. With the rate of 35 rupees an egg, if I have 10,000 flock and my flock performs 10 eggs below standard, calculate the amount and my capacity, laying capacity, housing capacity is 1 lakh, calculate, it will go into 3.5 crores. So it has a lot of economics importance, which is very important. As already mentioned, any deficient in energy intake will readily translate into egg numbers or smaller eggs or both. So either it will reduce the egg weight or the production will drop down. Shall I continue this one? Protein part? So let us come to the protein. So little attention is paid to the amount of protein consumed by the hen. Most breeder diets contain between 16% to 18% of the protein. With variable feed intake during the laying period, daily protein intake obviously varies. Because the feed consumption, as the quantum changes, the daily intake of protein will obviously change. No? Many breeders are fed up to 168 grams of feed per day or even more. Thus, protein intake could range per bird per day from 25.6 gram to 28.8 gram. And in many cases, it may go higher. So here, the calculation of protein requirement of the bird, you know. So using value generator for commercial layer, the protein required to produce 65 gram of egg containing 7.8 gram of protein should be around 7.8 divided by 0.55. This is the efficiency, suggested efficiency of dietary protein utilization for egg production. So protein required for egg production here finally came to this 14.2 gram. Okay. And what is protein requirement for the maintenance of the breeder bird? With an estimated total endogenous loss of nitrogen, including feeder loss, to be 200 milligram per kg of body weight to the power 0.75, a 3.5 kg breeder hen will require 770 milligram of nitrogen per day to meet her maintenance requirement. Converting this to protein required is a factor multiplied by, it is 4.48 gram of protein. With 55% efficiency in converting dietary protein to the body protein, the hen would require 4.48 gram divided by efficiency factor, it is 8.15 gram of protein intake per day to meet her maintenance of protein requirement. The total protein requirement, this is for egg production we have calculated 14.2 gram and for maintenance we have calculated 8.15 gram. So how much the need of the protein is 22.4 gram of protein is sufficient for a hen to lay 65 gram of egg every day. Here the no allowance has been made for body weight gain because it is minimal. Much of this gain will be fat deposition and thus a minimum of body protein would be deposited. Not every bird in a flock is laying an egg day. Does your bird lay every day eggs? No. So I calculated on per day basis. If suppose bird lays an egg every day, this is protein requirement. Protein required for egg production per day is only the 14.2 gram of protein multiplied by percent production of considering 65 gram of egg. The daily protein required of a flock of broiler breeder is less than 22.5 gram. This is estimates. This study has been done. So how the protein is partitioned? Partitioning the breeder's protein requirement. How the bird partition the protein? Around 80% of the energy consumed is partitioned to meet the hen's requirement of maintenance, including weight gain and activity. And reverse is the case with protein. Approximately 64% of the protein intake of the breeder is going to meet its requirement for egg mass production. Thus, the main factor influencing the protein requirement of the broiler breeder is egg mass output, not body maintenance, as in the case of energy. So here I conclude, body weight control of the breeder hens during rearing and productive phase is very important. This is because as your birds has grown to bigger size than standard, you will obviously require more energy or more feed and the more expenses on feeding, you know. As body size, body weight increases, maintenance requirement also increases. Designing precise feeding program in relation to the energy requirement of the hen in given condition is key to optimize breeder performance. It's energy, then protein. Energy is, always remember, energy is the first limiting nutrient in breeders. It's energy, then protein is important in optimizing the breeder performance. Thank you very much for giving me this opportunity. Thank you very much.